The Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1938. Excel Dropdown with file names from one folder using Power Query. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question is sent in by Aaron on YouTube. Wonder if it's possible to set up a worksheet that has a drop-down list that is linked to a folder. So when you put the new image file in the folder, the drop-down includes that file. Now, initially I thought, oh, well, this is going to have to be VBA. But if you have Excel 2010 or Excel 2013, 2010 any version with software assurance, 2013 Pro Plus or above, and you can download Power Query. This is a great new add-in for Excel. You can solve this problem. All right, so here's what I have. I have a folder called C:pix, and it has a bunch of pictures and a movie. I want just the picture files available and a drop-down. So we're going to come back here, add a new worksheet, and then under Power Query, say I want to get the data from a file, and then say that I want to get it from a folder. Enter the folder name, click OK. All right, now here in the query editor, we can choose which columns we want and don't want. And I just need the name of the file and the extension. So I can choose this and say remove columns. I can choose all of these. So click on the first one, shift click on the last one, and remove those columns. I could have done one more, remove columns. And then I want to keep just the pings, JPEGs, and get rid of the AVIs. So I'll open this little filter here and turn off the AVIs. That way we get only JPEGs and pings. Click OK. And then it's funny, once I've done that, I don't even need this column anymore. So I can remove that column. And then finally, it doesn't really matter whether it's a JPEG or a ping. So I want to get rid of that data. So that's going to be under Transform, split the column by a delimiter. And the delimiter is going to be a period, which is not in the list, so we'll use custom period, and at the rightmost delimiter, click OK. And finally, we don't need that column anymore. So home, remove columns. All right, we're good. We're going to close and load. All right, now the beautiful thing about Power Query is that it doesn't just do this once. It remembers all of the steps that we needed to get that data. All right, so if I would add more files to that folder and then refresh the data, it would automatically update. But we want to use this result in a data validation list. And before I can do that, I need to add a named range. Even though this is called Query 1, I have to add a named range on top of that. So I'm going to select all of the cells except for the header. And here I'm going to type a name such as my files, no space, press enter. See, it actually goes away because it thinks it already has a name. But we come back here and we'll set up data validation. Say that it comes from a list. And then equal my files. Click OK. And we have a list of all of those files. All right, so that's the first part. The first part is now working, but we need to be able to add more files to that folder and have it automatically update. Okay, so I'm going to drag some more files to that folder. We now have more files. And initially, see, they are not in the list. It's still just the original items in the list. So we have to come back to our query, and then on the Data tab, I'll go to Refresh All and say Connection Properties. And we have a couple of choices. First one is every time that we open this file, we'll go back out to that folder and refresh the data. If it's a kind of thing where someone's going to be adding new files to this folder, you know, every few minutes, we could actually say that we want to refresh the data every 5 minutes, every 1 minute even, although that might be a little bit annoying, maybe every 10 minutes, you know, whatever seems to make the most sense. We could always just force the thing to refresh by using Refresh All. So Refresh All goes back out to that folder, see, and we get the new items there. So one of those choices, either manually click Refresh All, simply set up the connections that way it refreshes every time we open the file, or have it open update every 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or whatever. And because I use a named range there, We should see the larger list of files in the dropdown. What a great idea from Aaron, and normally this would require some VBA, but luckily now, if you have Excel 2010, you can use Power Query and solve this without any VBA at all. Hey, I want to thank Aaron for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.